Are we alone in the universe? Once upon a time, we believed that we are the only intelligent life in the universe. But if you ask the experts today, they would say, alone? In all that space? Probably not. So, where are all the aliens? Scientists have been searching for intelligent ET life with radio telescopes for decades, but so far, they have found nothing. This conundrum is known as the Fermi paradox. Some scientists are nervous about ET contact with humanity. Stephen Hawking once talked about this scenario. Suppose we receive a signal from a planet like Gliese 832X. We answer back, revealing our location. But it turns out that life on Gliese 832X is much more advanced and sees humans as nothing but bacteria. They fly over here and destroy all humans on the planet. If aliens are out there, would they be friendly and benevolent beings or destroyers of worlds? This is a serious question today for astronomers. One particularly dark and terrifying hypothesis for the Fermi paradox is called the Dark Forest Theory. The idea comes from the Three Body Problem book series. The reasoning is laid out like this. The universe is a dark forest. Every civilization is an armed hunter hiding in the trees because other civilizations are all hunters just like them. Based on the prisoner's dilemma in game theory, if the hunter finds another life, the optimal course of action is to kill and eliminate it. In the dog-eat-dog world of intergalactic relations, most civilizations have intentionally kept radio silence out of fear that other civilizations might come and destroy them. And those civilizations that were not careful, they've already been destroyed. That's why it's so quiet. Dark Forest Theory is a bit of doom and gloom. It makes a few assumptions. One, that survival is the primary need of a civilization. And two, civilizations continue to grow and expand, but the resources in the universe are finite. Let's imagine a civilization called Zeta. They are a Star Trek type of civilization of blue humanoids, type 2 on the Kardashev scale. What kind of technology would they have? Faster than light travel? Check. Beaming technology? Check. Time travel? If needed. Food replicators in people's homes? Check. Capable of defending themselves? Check. It's safe to say the Zetas have evolved out of survival mode a long time ago. So coming over to the galactic boonies and killing some primitive Earthlings is probably not very high on their to-do list. Maybe Earth isn't worth contacting at all, and humans are not that special. And then there is the zoo hypothesis. The theory is that alien life intentionally avoids contact with Earth to allow our natural evolution and socio-cultural development. Similar to how people observe animals at the zoo. Try to picture this. Two Zetas, Lewis and Clark, were exploring the galaxy. They received a signal from Earth, so they swung by the planet. Lewis scanned the planet for life signs, while Clark plugged into our internet and started to learn about the planet. Suddenly, Clark shouted, "Oh my God, these primitive sapiens have nuclear weapons and they all hate each other. These two countries here are fighting a war right now." The Zeta visitors quickly decide that they don't want to set up diplomatic relations with humans on this planet. "Quarantine this place. Tell everyone not to come here. These people are not ready." Some people think zookeepers are subjecting humans to experiments. Others believe humanity is being isolated on purpose until we can evolve out of our self-destructive ways. In the 1996 movie Star Trek: First Contact, the pivotal meeting between humans and Vulcans occurred on April 5, 2063. The Vulcans live right next door to Earth. They had known about Earth, but they are not allowed to establish first contact due to the Prime Directive, the non-interference principle. In the Star Trek universe, Vulcans landed on Earth shortly after Earth humans had successfully invented the warp drive, a technology for faster-than-light space travel. Pre-warp societies are carefully avoided by spacefaring aliens, there to be left alone for their own good. Just think about it. If Vulcans landed today, they wouldn't be able to deal with the people here. Humans would be begging Vulcans for exotic technology, resources, and knowledge, and at the same time still having wars with each other. Worse, a significant portion of the population would start worshiping the Vulcans as their new gods. They would hate it. Experts today predict the first contact will happen in the lifetime of the current generation. and it will be a profound rite of passage for humanity. Perhaps our cosmic neighbors are just quietly waiting and watching in silence, hoping someday we can evolve into a more enlightened civilization. And when we're ready, they will come and say hello. Thank you for watching this video. If you like our content, the best way to support us is to share and like this video. Subscribe to our channel so you never miss a new episode.